There's only two kind of olives in the world. You got a green olive, and then you got black olives. How many of you have ever seen a green man? Okay. Right. They say that they are green men on Mars, but we still have yet to see them, right? So, when we get the term olive skin, brothers and sisters, they're talking about jet black skin. You're the same color. They're not talking about green, they're not talking about cream color.
Only from Mars.
This young black sister from the Sudan.
Shalom, shalom. Welcome to an overview slash preview slash synopsis of the Israelite Heritage Lecture. My name is Obadiah Yisrael, and I'll be your presenter. I'll be presenting this information to you. For those of you who may not be too familiar with the Hebrew language, shalom is a Hebrew word that means peace. It's a greeting used among Hebrews. Well, the Hebrew Israelite Heritage Lecture has been in operation since April of 2004. We began traveling the country, disseminating the information and explaining from the Bible or scriptures, from history and archaeology, who the true children of Israel are. Now, the children of Israel are the people mentioned in the Bible. They're mentioned in scripture from Genesis to Revelation. Moses, King David, Solomon, the prophets, Yehoshua the Messiah, his apostles, all of those men were Hebrew Israelites. They were descendants of Israel. And in our lecture, we proved that the so-called black people of the Americas, the ones that were brought here in slave ships during slavery, during the transatlantic slave trade, are indeed, without doubt, direct descendants of those ancient Israelites spoken of in the Bible. This lecture takes you on a journey in truth, as we call it. We take you on a journey from Jerusalem through Africa to the Americas, and we reveal and present the lost history of the so-called black people of the Americas. Now, when I say the black people of the Americas, I'm talking about not only the ones in North America, I'm talking about the ones in Central America, I'm talking about the ones in South America, the ones in Mexico, all the ones, as I just stated, that got here during the transatlantic slave trade over 400 years ago. We are direct descendants of the Israelites. That event in itself was prophesied to happen in the Bible. The Bible said that we would be brought into slavery in ships and be sold unto our enemies for male and female slave. Now, in our lecture, it is a slideshow. We have a slideshow presentation. The slideshow is generated through Microsoft slideshow program called PowerPoint. It's a very, very, very dynamic show because we have images, we have the scripture, we have all of this information documented. Information to back up everything that we're presenting. When we present a scripture, we got images to back up that scripture. We got historical information to back those up. So we're proving this and we're presenting our case and we're making it airtight. And as we have traveled so far around the country, the slideshow has just mystified a lot of people because they did not understand this, and they did not understand really what the Bible was saying, that the Bible is really speaking about them, the so-called black people or the so-called African Americans. And so when we present this beautiful slide presentation, and it is so visual because we understand that our people are a visual people. If we can see it, then we can believe it more. If I just come to you telling you some things and I have nothing to back up what I'm telling you, I have nothing to show you, then you may not be too keen to believe what I'm saying. But if I can back that information up with images, with documented proof, and just show you these things, and then you may want to understand, and you may be open to understand more. Now, this DVD that we're presenting here, this presentation, is for those who have an interest in hosting the lecture. The way we have the lecture set up is that if a person, group, organization, congregation get in contact with us and want us to bring this lecture to their city, they call us, get in contact, and they set up a date, and we give them the whole overview of what the lecture is, what is required, and how we can go about getting this event done. So that's what this right here, this video, is showing you, how to actually get the lecture done. What does it take to bring this lecture to your town? Not only that, but to give you an overview of what this lecture is all about, because we want you to feel confident that when you present this information to your community, to your church, to your organization, that it won't be something that you will feel bad about doing. So we want you to understand that how powerful this is and how on point it is. I want to briefly go into the two parts that we present in the lecture. We present the lecture in two halves. The lecture is approximately 2.5 to 3 hours long. That can include also the question and answer session, because we have a question and answer session immediately following the end of the presentation. Now, we have broken the lecture down into two halves. We have an intermission period of 10 minutes between the first half and the second half. The first half of the lecture deals with the physical appearance of ancient Israel. This is the one where we go through scripture and we show that the children of Israel look like the ancient Egyptians. They look like the Ethiopians in appearance. In fact, the first part of the lecture is called The Physical Appearance of Ancient Israel, the Israelites and the Sons of Ham. Now, this is very interesting. For those of you who may not know who Ham was one of the sons of Noah, and we explain this throughout the lecture. But the sons of Ham have been traced to the families of Africa, and we explain all this within the lecture. But we show that the true Israelites look like the black Egyptians, and they look like the black Ethiopians. And we show you images of what the ancient Egyptians of biblical time look like, and we show you the scripture which states that the children of Israel look exactly like those Egyptians. So that's how we deal with the physical appearance, and we show, like I say, with the Ethiopians also. And then from the physical appearance, we deal with another aspect of the biblical Israelites, and this is called the curses. Now, the Most High put curses or punishments upon his people Israel because they were so disobedient to him. Now, he made a contract with the Israelites and the Israelites only. He said if the Israelites would keep his laws and teach his laws to the other nations, because all of the nations on the earth were sinning, that he would make Israel a mighty, righteous nation. And he said, listen, Israel, but if you don't do this, then you're going to be cursed. So we go into the scriptures and we look at the curses that were put upon the children of Israel. And the Most High said in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, around the 45th verse and 46th verse, the Most High said that these curses were to be upon the children of Israel for a sign and for a wonder. Now, what that means is that a sign is an indicator. It indicates that whatever people are suffering from all these curses are the children of Israel. So we present this information in the lecture also. We show the physical appearance of the Israelites, and then we show those curses. You know, slavery was one of those curses, coming to slavery in ships, having going to prison, having our children taken away from us and given to other people, which is happening to us today in with the foster care system. We explain this throughout the lecture. We have documented evidence of this. A disease-stricken people. These are some of the curses that were put upon the children of Israel. And the Most High said, whatever people are suffering, these curses are my people, because he has scattered his people around the world. But we explain all of this in detail in the lecture. And those are the two parts that we present. We present the first part, the physical appearance. We take a 10-minute intermission. And then we come back and we present the second part. I am the speaker and the presenter of the lectures, Obadiah Yisrael. I want to briefly just, you know, give you a little overview also of the equipment that we use. And if you decide to host a lecture, the equipment that you would need. The slideshow, as I mentioned, is a PowerPoint or computer-generated slideshow. So we have a multimedia projector that we project the images onto the screen with. It's an Epson projector, one of the ones on the high end, because we had to get something that would show good according to the lighting situation, whether there's a lot of light, whether there is a little light, where it's black and, you know, the room is black, is dark, the projector would still show clearly, but we prefer, you know, to dim the lights because it shows even better. So we have a multimedia projector, a laptop, a Dell laptop that we use is to generate the actual, you know, slideshow. So we use that, and we have other equipment. We have a projector screen, and we have a PA system, but those things are kind of hard to travel with because they're so heavy and so big. So if you decide to host a lecture, whatever venue you go to, we would ask you to have the venue, to see if the venue have a PA system and a projector screen. Those are the things that we would need besides the equipment that we already have. But if it comes down to that, the venue where you're hosting the lecture doesn't have that, we can always bring ours. But we would prefer to just, you know, travel with the projector and the laptop. That would make it so much easier. But if we have to, we will bring the projector screen and the PA system. So those are pretty much the things that we would need to know from you. If the venue where you plan to host it, if they don't have a projector screen, if they have a large white wall, that is even better. Well, not better, but it will do. It would do just fine. It would be the same or equivalent to a projector screen. So if the venue has a large white wall, that would do also. We would love that. So we have a projector, we have the laptop. If you can check with and see, do they have a PA system and a projector screen? If no projector screen, a large white wall and just a lot of outlets. Now, as I mentioned about the question and answer session, we've noticed that during some of the lectures, you can have people there that don't really have any intention on learning or spreading, you know, news, that they want to come and disrupt things. So it's up to you as the host of the lecture whether you want to go with one or two of our question and answer sessions. I call them styles. One style we can do is that we can do what's called pretty much the ordinary style of a question and answer session, which means that when we begin the session, that we have a microphone set up, or we can have a person with a microphone travel around the room, and just people raise their hand, and if they have a question, they ask the question, and we try to keep the questions pertaining to the topic of the lecture. We don't want to go off and talk about a whole bunch of different other things, because we want to keep it right here centered on what they just seen, because that can help their understanding even greater. We can give information, or if they have a question, then maybe we can open up and we can give more information that we were not able to present in the lecture. And so the question and answer centered around the lecture topic is key. So we can do that. We can have the people to come up and, you know, raise their hand, and they ask a question and I answer it. Or we can have where when the people first come into the venue, and as they're taking a seat, we can pass out cards to them that have, you know, they can put the name, the address, and all those things down, email address. And they, as the lecture go on, and if they have a question, they can write the question down. And then right before we begin the question and answer session, we can collect those cards, and we can, you know, bring those cards up, and then we can pick a few topics within those questions. And then, you know, not really topics, because all topics, as I stated, you know, shall be dealing with the lecture, but we can pick a few questions, and we can do it like that. It wouldn't be censorship, but it would be so we can keep down the confusion that can arise by people who wants to do nothing but throw confusion out there, because I have witnessed this. And so we can do it that way. We can have the cards, or we can just have the people stand up and ask questions. But the question and answer session has been one of the big things of the lecture, because it really opens up people's understanding, and it just, they have questions, and those questions get answered there at the podium, because I'm not afraid to answer questions. I welcome questions every time we go out on these lectures. And in fact, the question and answer session, sometime it lasts a long time, and that's one of the reasons that, you know, if you have a certain amount of time on the venue and we have to get out of there at a certain amount of time, you know, it would be better that we take the cards and we pick a few questions from the cards and then, you know, answer the question like that. Because I have been in situations where we have had question and answer sessions for 2 and 3 hours. You know, the people were just so drawn by the information, and they were just so taken back by it that they, you know, didn't want to leave. We had a lecture in Michigan where we stayed there to midnight. It was after midnight when we got out of there, because we had like a 5-hour long question and answer session, and it was very good. But then we, you know, I was answering questions about, you know, many biblical topics. So we can do it like that, you know, if we want to keep down on the time of the question and answer. Because if we have with the card situation, if we have too many cards and we can't take all the questions, I will take the cards back home with me, and I will answer the questions if the people give me a way to contact them, email or post office box, or, you know, post office mail, wherever. If they give me an address, and I can, you know, take those home and look through them and, you know, try to answer them. So that's how we can deal with the question and answer session. And I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, this lecture would be great for your community. Everywhere we've gone, we have gotten positive response, especially from people who have never heard this. We have got super positive responses from people who have heard this. I mean, brothers and sisters that have been in this 30 and 40 years have known this, have given great response to the lecture, and they said that they have seen things in this lecture that they did not even know, and they have come to a greater understanding of certain topics that was presented that they didn't, you know, have a greater understanding of, even though they've been in it 30 years. So this lecture is dynamic. It is dynamic. It is a treat for any and everybody that would like to bring this to their community. So that is the overview. We deal with the physical appearance, the curses. We have the intermission right after the physical appearance, and we have a question and answer session where we take questions from the audience. And now let's look at the cost. You see it right up on the screen. There it is, cost. This lecture is so inexpensive for the information that's offered. You know, you have Christian ministers that are traveling around the country teaching falsehood. A lot of them are teaching falsehood, and it costs $10,000 and $20,000 to bring them to your town. We're just a small fraction of that. Okay, this is the cost involved. The person who wants to host the lecture, this is you who's listening and looking at this DVD. If you want to host a lecture, you get in contact with us. You would have to pay for my Obadiah's travel and hotel stay. Right now we do the lectures on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, because we know that it's greater, because the people are a little more settled on the weekend, meaning that they don't have to get up and go to work. They don't have to take the children here. They don't have to take them there. So it's more better for the weekend, because you can, that's when you can grab the people. Now, Saturday night seems to be the best night to have the lecture, because you catch the Sunday crowd, and then you know, you have the people who have been doing whatever they're going to do on the Saturday. They have now finished, you know, shopping or whatever, traveling, and now it's like the evening, like Saturday around 7. So the hotel stay for me would more than likely be a weekend or a two-night stay. I would get in on a Friday and probably leave on a Sunday. So you pay for the travel, the hotel stay. And we used to have a donation of $250, but we're pretty much going to cut that back, and just, we would take up like a donation from the audience. We have been putting forth, you know, money out of our pocket, and we have, wow, we have had to turn down so many lectures because we literally went broke. You know, we were traveling and you know, for expenses and so forth. We literally went broke, brothers and sisters. So we came up with it with the $250 donation. That's how we originally had it, but we may just go to a donation from the audience. It all depends on the host. If the host can afford to pay the $250 donation, then that's what we'll go with. But if they can't, then we'll just take up a donation from the audience. And the host pays for the travel and the hotel, then, you know, we have the lecture, and then we'll, you know, take up a small donation from the audience. This, you know, we're not doing this for money. This is our job. This is what we do, but we're doing it to bring the truth, and we're doing it to spread the truth to the people, to the world. This is not, we're not getting rich on this. We are not at all, and we're not trying to get rich. The money that we make from this goes back into our little ministry here to help us, you know, continue to spread this information to the world. That's what we're trying to do. And we're not the only ones. There are other brothers and sisters, Hebrew Israelites, that are doing this. And so that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to help spread the truth to the nations. So that's what the donation would be for, you know, even taking up the donation from you know, from the audience. That's just to keep everything that we have going. You know, we have to continue to, you know, have our equipment, you know, just the things we need to continue to travel the country. If we had the money put up, or if this was, you know, a way we can do it freely, you know, we wouldn't have charged, you know, well, we're not charging, but we would not take up a donation. You know, we would just bring the information, you know, do what we have to do and leave. But brothers and sisters, this, to bring us to your town, would be probably less than, I would say, $700. It would be let's say less than $1,000, just because it all depends on how much the airfare is from what, you know, where we're coming. I'm coming from Chicago, and so it depends on, you know, what the airfare is. So probably less than $1,000, you can bring this lecture to your town and spread the information to your people. Now, it's upon the host whether they want to charge an admission fee. Most of the lectures that we've gone on, we've done them free, you know, free admission. So it's up to the host whether you want to do that or not, whether you want to try to offset some of the cost by charging an admission fee. Or you can even charge out boot fee, or you know, you have merchants to come. And if we do it like on a Sunday, because, you know, we don't sell on the Sabbath day, the seventh day. That's the day, we're supposed to focus in on the Most High. And so we try to come back from all those labors and works and so forth. So if you want to, you know, you can even, you know, charge merchants to set up a little booth within the venue area, if the venue would allow that. And then, you know, you can try to offset some of the costs too, if you want to do it that way, or even have a fundraiser. But brothers and sisters, we have to get this information out. We have to get it to the people. That's the primary point of this. We have to get the people, we have to get the information to the people. So as I stated, you know, we're not here to get rich, because I know some people, you know, who don't really want to know the truth would try to put something like that out, but that's not so. You know, we do not do this for money. We do this for the love of spreading the truth to the people. And it just so happened that in this day and time, it takes money to do that. So that is pretty much it, brothers and sisters. That's the overview of the Israelite Heritage Lecture. I hope it was enough information for you. I hope that you like what you heard. I hope that you really consider bringing us to your town, really consider bringing this information to your people. Now, one last thing. When you rent out the venue, make sure that it holds at least 125 plus people. 125 plus, would, you know, that's the smallest that we would that we want to deal with. We want to pack the people into the place, brothers and sisters. We want to sell out. Well, not sell out, but just fill up, because we want the people to come to hear this information. So if we can get a venue that holds at least 125, if it holds 200, if it holds 300, that's even greater. So at least 125 plus people. And another thing just came to mind, because I just want to explain this briefly. The reason that I get in, or I want to come in like on a Friday, is because I want to spend a little time with the host. I want to get to know the host, you know, the host family, and just get to know the person that's bringing us to that town. And I would like to spend a day, come in that Friday and, you know, spend a day, spend some time with that person, and just get a feel for who you are, and you know, so we can have a better openness and a better connection, whereas we can build from this. You know, not only can we bring the information there, but we can have you know, we can build something from this. Whereas if you are a brother that is in knowledge and you have some knowledge, and maybe you can open up a class and start to teach this to the people that have witnessed this lecture, and then they want to know more. So I would like to come there just, you know, to spend a few moments with you. That's why I want, you know, we come in on a Friday and, you know, leave Sunday. So the hotel stay would be for two nights. And we, I think that is pretty much it. That is pretty much it. You know, I touched on everything that, you know, that is needed, everything that we, you know, need from the venue, the information that you would need, just what the lecture covers. Oh, also, when you book with us, and you for certain that we're going to come there, we would send you flyers. We will send you flyers by email, and you can print these flyers out and hand out these flyers. If you can get radio advertisement, if you want me to come on like a radio show and do interviews so we can advertise the lecture, that is also great. We would, you know, I would also do that. So that is pretty much it. I think that is it. I think I covered everything, brothers and sisters. And so if you really decide, you pray about this and let the Most High put it on your heart, and if it is His will, then we will see you there, we will be in your town, and we will be bringing the truth to you and to your community in the name of the Most High Yah. And our lecture is dynamic. We're not bragging, we're not boasting, none of that, but it's just from the standpoint that we're bringing the truth to the people, and the truth is great. We have had multi-racial audience in some of the cities we have visited. We have whites there. We have Jews. And in fact, when I was in Kansas City, one of the Jews told me, he said, everything that you have presented on the screen, I believe. I know that's the truth. And he went farther to say, I don't understand why others don't understand this truth. So as this is going off, brothers and sisters, right there on your screen, there should be some of the commentaries and just what people have been saying about the lecture after have been a witness to it. So you see those comments going up on the screen right now. And that's what the brothers and sisters are saying. That's actually what they were saying. We wanted to show you some live footage of some of the lectures, but we don't have that footage available right now. So maybe in another DVD that, you know, that we create for a overview, we can add some live footage. But as you have seen all the images, as you have seen all the quotes from scripture, have you seen the quotes from the people? on the screen, and you have heard my voice explaining this to you. I hope it has piqued your interest, because it is ultra important that this information gets to the world. Don't hesitate. Don't let the devil bring you down. Don't let him change your mind, because he's going to tell you, you don't need to do that. Why are you going to waste your time trying to get that lecture? Don't let him do that to you. Do it. Do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. We're here. We have the information. We have everything ready. All you have to do is bring us there, and we're there, and we're going to show the people the Most High. We're going to show the people why they have suffered for over 400 years, why they as a people have always been on the bottom, and why they as a people are going to once again be the rulers of the planet. This is not racism. We don't deal with racism. This is truth. That's all we're dealing with, brothers and sisters. And I hope that if you're a Christian listening to this, a Muslim, whomever you are, whatever religion, remember this. Every black man, woman, and child, regardless of your religion, must hear this truth. This is not about religion. It has nothing to do with religion. This has to do with a people, a heritage, and the Most High of the universe. So with that being said, my brothers and sisters, my people, I hope that this has once again piqued your interest. I hope I have explained it good enough for you. If you have any questions, there is our information right there on the screen. Please do not hesitate to call us. Please do not hesitate to get in contact with us today. If you call, because we have a heavy call volume sometime, leave a message and we will get back in contact with you. Let us know what you're calling for. Let us know that you're calling for the Israelite Heritage Lecture, whether you want to bring it to your city, whether you want more information. Let us know in that phone message what it is, and we will get back in contact with you. And Yah willing, we will be able to schedule a date. A date. So, brothers and sisters, there's so much in our history that they have been hiding from us. There's so much that we just didn't know. But, oh, it's so glorious today, because that information is being brought back to us. Oh, hallelujah. So I hope this has come across to you. I hope that you find it in your heart to do this, because this is important. This is what I do. Brother Obadiah Yisrael, he travels to the people. You know, I cannot sit back and wait for the people to come here. I have to come to where the people are. And the people are all over the place. We have been scattered all over the world. So, I'm ready, brothers and sisters. I'm ready. If you're ready, let's get this together and let's do this. And I hope everything, once again, was explained to you. This is the overview of the Israelite Heritage Lecture. We do these lectures year-round. All year, and hey, even if you want to do it within midweek, we are able to do that. But our suggestion is just, you know, on the weekend where you have people off from work and so forth and so on, and not as busy as they are through the weekday. So that is it, and we are out of here. This is this lecture is brought to you by the Israelite Heritage. We are restoring the forgotten heritage to the forgotten people. And I'm signing off. I'm your brother, Obadiah Yisrael, and I hope to see you soon. I hope to come to your city. I hope to come there to meet you. And once again, I hope to see you soon. In the name of the Most High Yah, through his son, Yehoshua, the Messiah, who has been given to us as a Messiah, Redeemer, Savior, I leave you in peace as I greet you in peace with the ancient Hebrew words of peace. Shalom.